What up, players? It is Warboss Tay back up in this mug. Welcome to an update video of my Crimson Hunter painted in the BL Tan colors, that vibrant green and white with the black fine work. I am so excited to be working on this model. I'm going to show you how I got along. I'm going to show you some pictures. I'm going to give you the inside scoop, the Warboss Tay technique on how I got it from unprimed but assembled, which you might remember the video that I did a couple weeks ago, to where it is now, and my plans to finish it and get it sent off by the end of the week. So the main thing that I wanted to do was to paint a lot of even coats with my airbrush, kind of hone up on my airbrushing skills, because it's been a while since I've used my airbrush. And to facilitate that, first I primed the model, the top of the model, with Dark Angels Green. And then I flipped it over, and then I primed the bottom of the model with Corax White. And then I picked out the white areas using Celestra Gray, which is a nice, thick foundation paint that doesn't streak and doesn't leave a lot of thinned out areas where you could see underneath. It's, if you shake it up and you apply at least two layers, then it'll make your white paint that you paint on top of that a lot better. It'll give it a better finish and a nice base of a nice light gray to make that white pop. Speaking of the white, what I used was, I think it was a Vallejo white. I've tried using in the past Ceramite White and White Scar from Games Workshop, and I haven't had any luck with those paints. But the paint always separates in the pots, no matter how hard I shake them. Somehow air gets in when I'm not looking, and then the pots are ruined. So I flip my table over, and I've switched over to Vallejo for my whites. Even though Games Workshop makes a lot of great colors, like, for example, after the Dark Angels Green, I sprayed on some Minotaur, which is an airbrush badger color. I think it's forest green, which is perfect for a highlight color. And then on top of that, I glazed a very watered down Warpstone Glow from Games Workshop. And so you get a beautiful contrast and nice blended effect. When you glaze something, you want to make sure you thin it down with a lot of water, or I guess you could use a paint thinner, acrylic thinner, but I mostly just use water, and then I thin down the paints. Use a lot of water, and make sure that when you're painting that glaze on, you don't let it pool, because then it'll create a lot of ugly water marks. So after I'd done the greens, and then I went over with the whites, and I made sure that the white areas on the fins were nice and vibrant, I went over the gems with black and just painted the entire gem black. And then in three steps, I used Corn Red, Mephiston Red, and then Wild Rider Red, and little crescent shapes to do all of the gem work. And as you get brighter, you get increasingly thinner with your crescents. And I started from the upper right of the gem, I went to the bottom right of the gem, and then to the bottom left. And the goal is you want to leave that black paint of the gem in the upper left-hand corner, as well as in the edge of the gem. So after doing that, I put a little dot of white paint in the upper left corner where it's all black. You don't want that white paint to really be too thick, and you don't want it to be large, but you want it to just create a nice focal point to create the illusion of light reflecting off the gem. The coup de grace, the final part of that puzzle, is you take some gloss varnish and you paint over the gem, and it creates a beautiful glossy, glassy, gem-like surface look. So, I mean, that's something that I've used for forever, and if you're new to my channel, you might not have heard me talk about it, but it's that crescent technique is of highlighting the gems is something that I've used pretty much since day one. I think I read it in an old How to Paint Citadel Miniatures book from Games Workshop, and I've used it ever since. So that was for the gems. The pilot, I wanted to keep him all dark with just a little pop of that color. So I highlighted him up with Mechanica Standard Gray, then Dawnstone, and then the greens. I just copied the green color scheme for the rest of the jet. And then, oh yeah, I'm highlighting, you can see I'm starting to bring up the edges with Moot Green, which is a nice bright yellowish green. Some people don't like using Moot Green as a highlight color for your Eldar because it almost creates it a cartoony look, but I really, really like the way that Moot Green makes your Eldar look alien. The color and the bright blended up color of, if you do it clean and you really transition your colors nicely, I think Moot Green on top of Warpstone Glow is one of the best color combos, because it's still green, but it's got a bright neon yellowish quality to it that I think is just fantastic for Eldar. If I was doing Salamanders or a Space Marine chapter, then maybe I might not use Moot Green, or maybe I might just use a very, very tiny amount of it. But for Eldar, I think it just looks fantastic. So I still have to paint the rest of it, or I still have to do the rest of the highlighting work. But like I said, this was just a work in progress to show you how I got to this point. After the gems are done, the pilot's done, I went and I took some Coelia Green shade. You could also use BL Tan Green. Those are both shades from Games Workshop. Or you can take your Dark Angels Green, or just a nice dark green color, and you can thin it down to a wash, because what you're doing is a focused application of that wash in the recesses, in those panel lines. So you can see how those lines on the jet look really dark, very nice and dark, and that's that Coelia Green shade. You need a very thin tipped brush, or a pointed brush, with a brush with a fine point, because if you load up your brush with too much wash, or if you use a brush that's too thick, for example, that wash will get onto the panels. And if that wash dries, it's really, really hard to paint back over, because it creates a very ugly line, and especially at the edge where the wash dries and meets the rest of the painted panel, it's not that good. So definitely make sure you've got your wrists braced against each other. You're using a nice, very thin pointed brush with a good tip and with a good point. And yeah, then have fun, because man, when I started painting those panel lines, I really, really got motivated. I was really seeing the all that work coming together, and it was really fun. It's a little tedious because you're looking for every single panel line on the entire jet. But believe me, once you get it done and you hold it back and you look at it, it no longer looks like it's just painted with one flat coat of color. It really starts to pop. That contrast between the dark and the light really, really looks good. So the next thing I did was I worked on the black areas. I just took Abaddon Black. I painted the thrusters, the weapons, those vents you can see right above the vine work, and then the power core in the back, which is like the little engine turbine coming out of the back of the thing. Then I went to work on the vines. The vines was so much fun. The vines were so much fun to paint. The first thing I did was I took my Micron pen, 0.005, the smallest tip you can have, and I just drew that vine pattern. Just a lot of wavy S's, and once I made the main vine, I did little branching vine areas. You could see some points that just kind of go to nowhere. They just branch out, and that's to kind of help the eye process the entire thing, to show that it's not just one thick vine, but that it branches off. And it also helps to not mask, but to take away the effect if you're a little bit messy with your thorns. And hopefully you shouldn't be, because you're going to be getting a lot of practice doing that thorn work. But once I drew in the center of the vines and all of the different branching off little vine pieces, I painted it in with Abaddon Black, using again the same brush I used for the panels, because you want to make sure you have a very thin line. And then I did the points, the thorns, and that's basically just painting a line coming out of the vine, and then smoothing the sides out, turning it into a triangle. So basically you're just doing like little lines coming off of the vine, and the lines can be long or short depending on how thick or tall or wide you want those thorns to be. And then you just, like I said, you do a little windshield wiper motion from the point at the tip, and you create your vine. You don't want it to be too thick, or else it looks like a little lump. You don't want it to be too thin, or else it'll look like a hair or something coming out of the center of that vine. But once I got through all of that, I just went over, play a podcast in the background or watch a movie or have a documentary going, because this is really the most tedious but the most rewarding part of painting any BL-10 model. It's that characteristic vine work that's on the side of all of their vehicles. I dread doing it, but when I'm finished and then I go back over and I highlight it with the Mechanica Standard Gray, you can see I just painted in the center of the thorns and the center of the vine, then I think it's so rewarding to look at. So thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions on how to paint BL-10, I can give you my tips and tricks. I actually use the same techniques for everything that I painted, just to be consistent with the Eldar start collecting Battle Force boxes. So I'll be doing a separate video for that. But thank you so much for watching, everybody. Don't forget to leave a comment before you go. Hit that like button and subscribe if you're not already. I always love seeing my little subscriber button tick up. Boop, 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 boop. And hit those links below if you want to follow me on Google and the painting community there, or Facebook or Twitter or any of that good stuff. Thanks so much for watching. Hope you guys are having a great day. Stay tuned for more from my studio, including Dark Angels characters, more Kingdom Death, Primaris Marines, and Ulthwe Eldar. Have a great day. See you in the next video.